This is a story that has me fired up tonight. And really, it's something that I'm going to remember for the rest of my life. Ask yourself the question, what do you think it would be like to stand on the Lincoln Memorial and give a speech off the top of your head? I don't know if you can prepare for that. I did my best. I had the honor of kicking off the One Nation rally on the steps of the Lincoln Memorial on Saturday. The passion in the crowd was unbelievable amongst the great Americans who traveled all across this country to fight for a better life for all of us and to try to right what has been wrong over the last few years as the party of no has tried to stop the progressive agenda. The forces of evil in the conservative movement are on a mission to take down the rally and marginalize the diverse crowd that attended. Conservatives want you to believe that, well, first of all, nobody showed up, and they're absolutely dead wrong about that. This Sunday, the Washington Post reported more than 400 groups endorsed the Nation Working Together rally, which organizers said drew a crowd of 175,000 people, about what they expected. Now, conservatives want you to believe that Glenn Beck's phony religious revival was way bigger than the One Nation rally. Well, let me take you back to the day of the Beck rally. On August 28th, 2010, at 6:32 p.m., CBS.com proved Beck's crowd was, as I said, no big shakes. An estimated 87,000 people attended the rally organized by radio talk show host and Fox News commentator Glenn Beck Saturday in Washington, according to a crowd estimate commissioned by CBS News. The company, AirPhotosLive.com, based the attendance on aerial photos it took over the rally. Now, to be fair, NBC News put the size of Beck's crowd at 300,000 people. So, somewhere in between all of this, 87,000, give or take $9,000 by that company, and 300,000 is reported by NBC. Pretty much, would you say that the size of the crowd is pretty much the same? I would. I was there. The people I saw, it was packed. So conservatives, I want you to pay very close attention. This is what a crowd of middle-class Americans who believe in universal health care, jobs, unemployment benefits, not kicking your neighbor to the side of the road, and of course, equal rights, social justice, and education for America. This is the official picture from the AP from our rally on Saturday. Packed house all the way back to the monument. And I refuse to allow the forces of evil distract from what the One Nation rally was all about. They want you to believe that I gave some controversial speech, that I had, you know, was hiding something. Well, here's my speech in its entirety for the record.
that sacrifice cannot profit those at the top all the time. This is about the people. This is about one nation. This is about our future. This is about our kids, our grandkids, the future of our country. We cannot back down. We will not back down. We must move forward. Are you one nation? Are you one nation? Are you one nation? For the last 2 years, President Obama, he's had to put up with the word no. 40 people in the United States Senate has held down the working man of America. 40 Republicans have decided to say no. While you suffer, while your jobs go overseas, while they strangle the money, they don't want to give it to the small businesses. They want to keep it at the top. They want to see President Obama fail. We cannot let that happen. We cannot let it happen. The Lord is blessing this march with a great turnout and a beautiful day. I leave you with a message. We cannot give up on November 2nd. We have not gotten everything we've wanted in the first 2 years. But we have to stand behind our leaders on the progressive agenda that is for the people and not always the corporations. It is for the family of America. The other side, they think it's about profit. They don't think it's about people. They don't want us to have health care. They want it for profit. We will get universal health care someday. If we let them do this to public education, we will be a different country. Just remember, the great thing about public education is when the doors open, everyone's welcome. The gifted, the challenged, the rich, the poor, those who need special help, those who can move forward in advanced classes. This isn't about just a few people with the money. This is about all the people in public education for the opportunity of America. We cannot let them tear it down. We must fight. We must push back. Our brothers and sisters, our union brothers and sisters across America. They have vilified you. They don't want you to organize in the workplace. They suppress your vote. They delay the organization of collective bargaining. We will not stand by silent. We, as one nation, must stand together, must fight the forces of evil, the conservatives in this country, across the board, want it for them. They don't want it for the people. They talk about the Constitution, but they don't want to live by it. They talk about our forefathers, but they want discrimination. They want to change this country. And we, as one nation, stand up this day and say, we will be there on November 2nd. We will not give up. We will continue to fight. Are you Americans? Are you Americans? Do you love this country? Then we must vote on November 2nd. God bless America. God bless our troops for keeping us safe. Let's move forward for the country.
Last Saturday in Washington, D.C., and I want to thank all of the people around the country who have emailed our show saying that they wanted to be there, but they couldn't be there. In some cities across America, they did rally, and it was quite a turnout. Hopefully, this will motivate Democrats to move forward. It was a thrill.